गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट. सो टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू द टॉपिक दैट इज इन्फ्लामेटरी हार्ट डिसीज. इन अर्लियर क्लासेस वी स्टडीड अबाउट द एंडोकार्डाइटिस, मायोकार्डाइटिस एंड इन द कंटिन्यूशन ऑफ द इन्फ्लामेटरी हार्ट डिसीज टुडे वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द पेरिकार्डाइटिस. सो फर्स्ट वन इज इंट्रोडक्शन. Pericarditis refers to the inflammation of the pericardium, that the membranous sac enveloping the heart. It is the swelling and irritation of the membranous sac which enveloping your heart is called pericardium. That means pericardium, it is the outermost layer of the heart. It is also called epicardium. It encloses and cover the heart. It is a membranous sac which provide protection and covering to the heart. So here the inflammation in the pericardium or epicardium layer is called pericarditis. It may be acute or chronic. ये acute भी हो सकता है और chronic भी हो सकता है. Next, associated with a sharp chest pain with the pericardium rug. I have already told you about the chest pain in the angina pectoris. So in this patient is also associated with the symptom of sharp chest pain and also the pericardium rub. Next one is it usually begins suddenly but doesn't last long. ये क्या होता है, हमेशा sudden start होता है लेकिन ये बहुत but is doesn't last long, लेकिन ये काफ़ी last long नहीं है. Next one is etiology. So first etiology is infection. Under this various type of infectious agent which also cause the pericarditis and other inflammatory heart disease. So under the infection, first is viral infection. Pericarditis is also caused because of the viral infection which cause inflammation in the pericardium. There are various type of causative agent like ecovirus, adenovirus, influenza A and B virus, enterovirus, mumps virus, Epstein-Barr virus, human immunodeficiency virus, that is HIV virus, herpes simplex virus, varicella zoster virus, measles, para influenza type 2 respiratory virus, cytomegalo virus, hepatitis virus A, B and C. So these all are the viral agent which cause the pericarditis. Next one is bacterial infection. It result from the direct pulmonary extension hematogenous spread. Hematogenous spread means spread through the blood flow, and because of myocardial abscess, because of endocarditis, any type of penetration or injury to the chest wall from the any outer side or external trauma or surgery in the chest, or any type of subdiaphragmatic suppurative lesion which is present in the chest. So these all are the factors which triggers the chance for the bacteria to enter in the body and cause the pericarditis. Next one is parasitic. Parasitic like it include the ant amoeba, Echinococcus and Toxoplasma. Fungal agent are also cause pericarditis like fungal infection which may cause acute pericarditis, that is include Histoplasma, Blastomyces, Aspergillus, Candida, and also there is chance of other type of infection which have already present in the body and it cause the pericarditis. Next one is myocardial injury. Under the myocardial injury, if the person already having myocardial infraction, any type of cardiac trauma means injury to the heart. Next one is post cardiac surgery. After the any heart surgery, hypersensitivity, if patient having any type of allergic reaction or hypersensitivity from any type of medication or from anything. Next one is collagen disease. Collagen disease also cause the pericarditis. Next one is rheumatic fever. Rheumatic fever, I have already told you in the rheumatic heart disease that what is rheumatic fever and how it cause the inflammation and infection in the हार्ट. नेक्स्ट वन इज इटियोलॉजी. इन द इटियोलॉजी फर्स्ट वन इज स्कैलरोडर्मा. इट रिफर्स टू अ ग्रुप ऑफ रेयर ऑटो इम्यून डिसऑर्डर इन विच द स्किन एंड कनेक्टिव टिश्यू आर टाइटन एंड हार्डन एंड इट इज अ प्रोग्रेसिव डिसीज विच इज एन इन्फ्लामेशन ऑफ द लाइनिंग ऑफ द हार्ट लाइक द पेरिकार्डियम एंड इट कॉज द पेरिकार्डाइटिस. नेक्स्ट वन इज सिस्टमैटिक ल्यूपस एरिथेमेटस. नेक्स्ट रूमेटॉइड आर्थराइटिस. नेक्स्ट वन इज एंटी माइग्रेन ड्रग विच ऑल्सो कॉज द कॉन्स्ट्रिक्टिव पेरिकार्डाइटिस. कॉन्स्ट्रिक्टिव पेरिकार्डाइटिस आई विल टीच यू इन द टाइप्स. नेक्स्ट वन इज स्मॉल पॉक्स वैक्सीनेशन समटाइम्स ऑल्सो कॉज द मायोकार्डाइटिस एंड विच फर्दर लीड्स टू द pericarditis. Next one is drug reaction. Under the drug reaction, various type of drug which also cause the pericarditis, like first one is procainamide, second one is doxorubicin, and third one is penicillin. Next one is pathophysiology. So first, due to any type of etiological factor, there is acute pericardial effusion. Pericardial effusion means fluid collection inside the pericardium. Next, it will lead the pressure of the pericardial cavity is increased because of the increase the hypertrophy of the pericardial cells. Next, which cause the filling volume of the ventricular diastole is decreased because of the decreased volume and decreased space between the pericardium and the heart. Next, that leads to the stroke volume decrease. Due to stroke volume decrease, that result in the lowering in the blood pressure. Another pathophysiology, first one is due to all the etiological factor, there is inflammatory process proceed in the pericardium, which cause the pericardial effusion that cause the fluid accumulation, the fluid which is accumulated in the pericardium, which is either serous type or purulent type or containing blood in the pericardial sac, which further leads to the increase intrapericardial pressure. Due to increase intrapericardial pressure, there is compression arises on the heart, which cause the decreased ventricular filling and emptying because of the low space in the pericardium, and which result in decreased venous pressure, decreased cardiac output, and decreased arterial pressure. So these all are about the pathophysiology. Next one is clinical manifestation. In the patient with pericarditis, we have seen many type of clinical features, sign and symptoms. First one is chest pain, which is the most common complaint among the patient in the pericarditis. The pain, the clinical features, the characteristic of the pain is sour, pleuritic, retrosternal and radiating to the left shoulder and relieved by the sitting up. Matlab jab patient agar sitting position mein hai to patient ko pain se relief milega and pain radiating to the left shoulder. Next one is can mimic angina or ischemic chest pain. It can also look like a angina pectoris. Next, can have fever, myalgia, patient look fatigue, heart failure is rare and it indicate the myocarditis. Pericardial friction rub is also present in the 85% of the patient and also is scratchy sound present in the patient. Sour piercing chest pain over the center or left side of the chest, which is generally most intense when patient take breath, shortness of breath. Next one is heart palpitation, low grade fever, sense of weakness, fatigue, and patient feeling sick, cough, abdominal or leg swelling. Next one is type of pericarditis. In the type of pericarditis, there are two main division. First one is acute and another one is chronic. In first one is acute, there is four types. There are four types. First one is serous. Second one is fibrous, third one is purulent, and fourth one is hemorrhagic. And in the other subdivision, that is chronic pericarditis. In this, there are two types. First one is adhesive and second one is constrictive pericarditis. So in first serous type, usually it is caused by the non-infectious inflammatory disease like rheumatoid arthritis, systematics, lupus erythematosus, scleroderma, which is a disorder of connective tissue, any type of tumor present, and uremia, excess uric acid present in the blood. Next one is bacterial pruritus may also cause the sufficient irritation to the pericardium and cause the inflammation of the pericardium, and viral infection antedates the pericardial inflammation. Next type is fibrinous. It is the most common type of pericarditis. It is an exudative inflammation. Exudative means in this the fluid is containing pus, and it looks like the bread and butter like appearance between the pericardial sac and the heart. Next one is the epicardium. It is means pericardium. It is inflated by the fibrinous exudate, means containing fibrous tissue and pus. Then the common cause of the this type of pericarditis include acute myocardial infarction, post infarction. Next one is uremia, radiation, and trauma. Next one is purulent or suppurative. In this red granular surface coated with the pus, lot of subsurface neutrophils up to 500 ml exudate present in the pericardium. Immunosuppressive patient can also have more chance to have this type of pericarditis, commonly seen in the patient with the empyema, mediastinitis, that means the inflammation of the mediastinum, endocarditis, patient having already burn or post pericardiodectomy. Next type is hemorrhagic. Hemorrhagic, that is blood mixed up with the fibrous or suppurative infusion, means there is a inflammation and fluid which is collecting inside the pericardium sac, that containing the blood and also containing some pus or suppurative infusion. Next, it is commonly caused by the tuberculosis or direct any neoplastic invasion, means if patient having any type of cancer, benign or malignant. It can also occur in case of the severe bacterial infection, and it also common after the any type of surgery which cause the cardiac tamponade, which I have already told you in the cardiac tamponade. Next one is clinical significance. Clinical significance is similar like the suppurative pericarditis. In the chronic pericarditis, there are two types. First one is adhesive and second one is constrictive. In the adhesive, it follow the suppurative pericarditis, cardiac surgery or radiation. That means after the suppurative pericarditis or any type of cardiac surgery or any type of radiation therapy, there is a chance of occurrence of the adhesive mediastinal pericarditis. And in this other types is constrictive pericarditis. Usually it is caused by the hemorrhagic, suppurative or seasonal pericarditis. In this, heart becomes encased in a layer of scar, means heart है उसके चारों तरफ एक scar की जो layers होती है उसका formation हो जाता है, and calcification which is usually 0.5 to 1 cm thick, जो कि कितना thick होता है, 0.5 to 1 cm. So these all are about the types of pericarditis. So under the acute there is 4 types, and under the chronic there are 2 types. Next one is diagnostic test. Firstly, we will take the history of the patient, and in the history we will take the history regarding the any previous medical history, previous surgery history, and all ask the patient about the all risk factor and causes which cause the pericarditis. Next, we will perform the physical examination. In the physical examination, the first finding is friction rub, which is present, the chest pain is present, breathing difficulty is present, which is the chest pain which is very sharp and radiating to the left shoulder, and all other type of sign and symptoms we also check in the patient. Next, other routine, beside the routine diagnostic evaluation, the other diagnostic tests are electrocardiogram, which is also called ECG, to check the heart rhythm and to see the voltage signal is reduced because of the excess fluid in the pericardium layer. Next one is echocardiogram, MRI, CT scan, it gives the all detailed picture of the heart and about the pericardium. Right-sided heart catheterization, which gives the information about the filling pressure in the heart. So here the filling pressure in the heart means filling pressure in the ventricle is decreased. Blood test to look for the markers or markers of the inflammation that suggests the pericarditis or any suspected systemic disease. In this, the cardiac biomarker is cardiac biomarkers is present in the case of the pericarditis. So this is the diagram. First diagram is echocardiogram and second one is electrocardiogram. Next one is management. Firstly, we will need to identify the cause, what caused the pericarditis in the patient, and if the possible, firstly we provide the analgesic for the pain. If the patient having fever, we provide the antipyretic and anti-inflammatory. For the anti-inflammatory effect, we will provide the anti-inflammatory drugs, that is non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs such as aspirin, ibuprofen, and in some cases we also provide the corticosteroid like hydrocortisone, prednisone, prednisolone. Next one is diuretics to remove the excess fluid, like we using the Lasix, furosemide. We provide the antibiotic and antifungal agent according to the infective agent which cause the pericarditis. Advise the patient to take the bed rest, to take the proper positioning, and take the low sodium diet. Next one is, if the pericarditis is chronic, recurrent, and cause the constructive pericarditis, then we perform the surgery. So in the surgical management, there are two types. First one is pericardiocentesis and second one is pericardiectomy. Under this, the pericardiocentesis, in this procedure a doctor use a sterile needle or a small tube or catheter to remove and drain the excess fluid from the pericardial cavity. इसमें क्या होता है, pericardiocentesis में हम क्या करते हैं कि एक small tube या catheter को हम क्या करते हैं pericardial cavity में insert कर एक needle को insert करते हैं और उसमें से जितना भी fluid जो excess है उसको कैथेटर के थ्रू हम बाहर रिमूव कर लेते हैं, ड्रेन कर लेते हैं. यू विल रिसीव अ लोकल एनेस्थेटिक बिफोर अंडर गोइंग द पेरिकार्डियोसेंटेसिस विच इज ऑफन डन विद द इकोकार्डियोग्राम मॉनिटरिंग एंड अल्ट्रासाउंड गाइडेंस. इसमें जो मेन थिंग क्या है कि इसमें हम क्या करते हैं, एक स्टेरॉयल नीडिल या एक स्मॉल ट्यूब या कैथेटर लेते हैं जिससे कि हम जो भी पेरिकार्डियल कैविटी में एक्सेस फ्लूड है उसको रिमूव कर सके. नेक्स्ट वन इज पेरिकार्डियेक्टॉमी. इन दिस वी रिमूव द एंटायर पेरिकार्डियम दैट हैज़ बिकम रिजिड एंड इट्स मेकिंग इट हार्ड टू पम्प. इसमें क्या करते हैं, जितना भी जो पेरिकार्डियम है जो डैमेज हो गया, हार्ड हो गया, थिकेंड हो गया है, हम उसको एंटायर क्या करते हैं, रिमूव कर देते हैं. मैक्सिमम जो पेरिकार्डियेक्टॉमी के जो पेशेंट होते हैं उसके बाद जो उनका हार्ट है उनको रिकवर होने में बहुत ज़्यादा टाइम लगता है क्योंकि जो हार्ट के ऊपर जो वर्कलोड है वो बहुत ज़्यादा बढ़ जाता है. नेक्स्ट वन इज पेरिकार्डियल विंडो. अंडर द पेरिकार्डियल विंडो, इन दिस प्रोसीजर ओपनिंग इज मेड इन द पेरिकार्डियम टू ड्रेन द फ्लूड दैट हैज एक्यूमुलेटेड अराउंड द हार्ट. इसमें क्या करते हैं, पेरिकार्डियम एक विंडो मतलब एक खिड़की, एक होल जैसा कटिंग हम कट करते हैं और वहाँ से जितने भी एक्स्ट्रा फ्लूड है, जितने भी एक्सेस अमाउंट में फ्लूड है उसको ड्रेन करते हैं. दैट इज कॉल्ड पेरिकार्डियल विंडो. नेक्स्ट वन इज नर्सिंग डायग्नोसिस. नर्सिंग डायग्नोसिस फॉर द पेशेंट विथ इन्फ्लामेटरी हार्ट डिसीज, लाइक फॉर द पेशेंट विथ एंडोकार्डाइटिस, फॉर द पेशेंट विथ मायोकार्डाइटिस, एंड फॉर द पेशेंट विथ पेरिकार्डाइटिस. सो फर्स्ट नर्सिंग डायग्नोसिस, दैट इज इन इफेक्टिव ब्रीदिंग पैटर्न रिलेटेड टू इन्फ्लामेशन ऑफ हार्ट मसल्स एज एविडेंस बाई द यूज ऑफ एसेसरी मसल्स एंड डिसिप्निया. सेकेंड वन इज इम्पेयर्ड गैसियस एक्सचेंज विच इज रिलेटेड टू फ्लूड एक्यूमुलेशन इन द लंग एज एविडेंस बाई शॉर्टनेस ऑफ ब्रीथ. डिक्रीज कार्डियक आउटपुट रिलेटेड टू वल्वलर डिसफंक्शन एज एविडेंस बाई द पुअर टिश्यू परफ्यूजन, इम्बैलेंस न्यूट्रिशन, लेस देन बॉडी रिक्वायरमेंट रिलेटेड टू एनोरेक्सिया एज एविडेंस बाई द लॉस ऑफ वेट. नेक्स्ट नर्सिंग मैनेजमेंट, फर्स्टली we advise the patient to take the proper bed rest, assist the patient with bathing if necessary, place the patient in the upright position to relieve from the breathing difficulty and chest pain, and if patient having sharp chest pain and very difficulty with the breathing, so we will provide the analgesic. एंड प्रोवाइड एनाल्जेसिक टू रिलीव द पेन एंड ऑल्सो प्रोवाइड द ऑक्सीजन टू प्रिवेंट द टिशू हाइपोक्सिया. हाइपोक्सिया दैट मीन्स डिक्रीज ऑक्सीजन कंसनट्रेशन इन टिश्यू. असेस द पेशेंट कार्डियोवास्कुलर स्टेटस दैट इज पल्स रेट ब्लड प्रेशर. वॉच फॉर द साइंस ऑफ कार्डियक टेम्पोनेट एंड मॉनिटर द पेशेंट पेन लेवल एंड इफेक्टिवनेस ऑफ द एनाल्जेसिक विच आर प्रोवाइडेड टू द पेशेंट. एक्सप्लेन ऑल द टेस्ट एंड ट्रीटमेंट टू द पेशेंट टू गेन द कॉपरेशन एंड कॉन्फिडेंस एंड टू रिलीव द एंजाइटी एंड फियर ऑफ द पेशेंट. एंड बिफोर गिविंग द एंटीबायोटिक्स ऑब्टेन अ पेशेंट हिस्ट्री फॉर एनी टाइप ऑफ एलर्जी बिकॉज समटाइम हाइपर सेंसिटिविटी कैन ऑल्सो कॉज द pericarditis. Next, tell the patient to resume his daily activities slowly and to schedule rest period into his daily routine for a while. So overall, the nursing management is, firstly, we will advise the patient to take the rest, to avoid the stress, to avoid the any type of trigger which can precipitate the pericarditis, and place the patient in the upright position, place the patient in the position to relieve from the breathing difficulty, provide the analgesic to relieve the patient from the pain, provide psychological counseling, and explain all the procedure to the patient to gain her cooperation, give the psychological counseling to the patient to relieve the anxiety and fear of him or his or her. Thank you.